Hey, sorry about that Sable thing. I should have told you earlier, but it all happened so fast.
It's okay. We're still best buds.
We're not best buds.
Well, that took a dark turn.
Anyway, Sable has the mayor's ear and unchecked authority. We've searched that address you gave me, found plenty of evidence of a bomb plot, but nothing that leads back to Martin Lee.
I'm working on that. Hey, MJ.
Hey, so I dredged up some records on Martin Lee's other business holdings. He's got places all over the city.
Huh. The locations line up with a map I found at that shipping business. I'll check them out.
Let me know what you find at each one, and I'll work on building a case.
You got it. I'm headed to Lee's office at Feast to see if I can learn more about why he's doing this, and what he's got planned next.
Okay. Say hi to May for me. Wait, you don't think she's in danger, do you?
No. Lee's only got one target on his mind. Norman Osborn.
Peter.
So if you're running this place while Mr. Lee's out of town, who's doing your old job?
Me. But I could always use more help. You know anyone?
Actually, I do. His name is Miles Morales.
Why does that sound familiar?
His father was being honored at City Hall.
Oh.
I talked to him at the funeral. He's a smart kid. He's just having a tough time.
I knew a boy like that once.
I remember it helped to, stay busy. Might help him, too. Here's his mom's number.
Thanks. I'll give her a call.
Hey, you haven't heard from Mr. Lee, have you?
No. Why?
Just curious. I've got a few minutes before work. I'm gonna look around, see if there's anything else I can do to help you out.
Oh, you don't have to.
I know. I want to. I should check out Lee's office.
Pete, glad to see you're okay.
Hanging in there.
May said you were at the bombing. I was praying for you.
Thanks. I appreciate it. What are you hiding, Lee? Lee's giving his powers to the others. How does Lee imbue these with his power? Bioelectric induction? Compressed phase shift? Lee sure is obsessed with masks. Is it a Jungian thing? Like, he needed to pretend to be someone else to let his darkest feelings out? Pretended to be a demon. Until he became one. This is all about Norman Osborn. His whole career. Lee must have been obsessed with him. Oscorp lost a lawsuit about improper clinical trials years ago. Did they cover this up? I've never heard of it. Creepy. This is the folder MJ found at the auction house. This might help us figure out what Lee's planning next.
Can feel my power growing, feeding off my anger. Father would say I've lost the path of balance, that he could never understand. The only way to fight a monster is to become one.
It's a burn room, wired to destroy evidence. police had found this. Or May. Don't want to think of what could have happened. Now, how do I get out of here?
Hello, Peter.
Mr. Lee. I thought you were out of town.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Martin, you're back.
You get that.
Thank you.
And heading off again shortly, I'm afraid. Just needed a few things from my office.
You must have heard about City Hall.
Yes. Tragic.
Peter was there. He was very lucky.
And an Osborne rally. I didn't know you were a fan. Well, what matters is you are both safe.
Amen.
But the bombers are still out there. Who knows what they've planned next?
I don't think you or May have anything to worry about. As long as you stay away from places you're not supposed to be. Well, I should go.
When will you be back?
When my work is done.
Wait, wait, wait! I finally got your evidence. Head to the Feast Center in Chinatown.
What am I going to find?
A nice lady named May Parker. And some really weird stuff hidden in Lee's office. But listen, he's got another attack plan.
Where? When?
Still working on that, but I think he's going to use something called Devil's Breath.
Sounds destructive. What is it?
A substance created by Oscorp. Probably a bioweapon of some kind. I have a folder full of info on it. I'm holding on to it for now. I'll send copies as soon as I can.
Okay, we'll check his office. If the evidence stands up, I'll put out an APB.
MJ, hey. Just checking in.
Peter, hey. Can I call you back?
I think you'll want to hear this. Wait, why are you whispering?
Just in the middle of something. How about we catch up over dinner? My place?
Oh, sure. I'll even cook.
Cool. See ya.
Wait. Remember how you told me about Lee's corrupting touch? I think I just saw it in action.
How?
Some perfectly nice homeless people just jumped me. Thing is, they had glowing eyes. And I remembered Yuri telling me something similar about the guard who released Shocker.
So Shocker was working for Lee? It's all connected.
There's more. But I guess we'll talk about it at dinner.
Yeah, see ya.
Dinner? What should I cook? Oh, hi, Doctor. How are you?
Parker! Exciting news. Come by the lab.
Now?
This is my divining moment. Can't wait to show you.
Cool. I've got dinner plans. Can I come by later?
Dinner can wait. You need to see this, Peter.
Okay. Be right there. Wonder if this means I have a job again. Guess I can stop by just for a minute. Just another call from Doc.
Peter, I wanted to make sure you're still available. I can't pay you yet, but I've pulled enough strings to keep the wolves from the door a bit longer. If we can get up and running, I know this new version of the project will attract investment. Massive investment. Stay ready.
Fingers triple crossed, Doc.
Agent stationed at the Tenderloin. What's your status?
Need reinforcements at Outpost Foxtrot. We're taking fire.
Hey, Doctor.
Hello, Peter. I'll be just a minute.
Wow. Look at all this new stuff. We really need to get better about organizing our workspace. Where did you get all this equipment?
Called in every last favor. Took out a few loans. It's like we're starting over once again. But this time's going to be different.
Our first volunteer subject, Lance Corporal Texidor. Lost his arm overseas and now just wants to hug his daughter again. You've been busy.
Just getting started. You know, until now, we've been looking at prosthetics from the wrong perspective. Why restore people to what they were when we can make them better? Okay, I think that should do it. Ready?
Everything okay?
Norman, you son of a...
Well, I know who you're not voting for in the next election. Sorry. I have a habit of making bad jokes in tense situations.
It was a good joke, Parker. Just a bit of an overreaction on my part.
No, don't worry. Why don't you take a break? I'll clean this up and get us ready for another test. So, hope you don't mind me asking, but it seems you and Norman have a bit of a history.
We were lab partners in college. Became friends. Decided to start a business. We both had visions of changing the world, just in different ways.
Wait, you were at Oscorp when it started?
I'm half the reason it's called Oscorp. In grad school, everyone called us the O's. Add Corp to that, and, well, it is a catchy name.
Well, why'd you leave?
Norman became more and more obsessed with genetics. He started a project I considered unethical. And there was this... Anyway, lawyers got involved. I chose to leave in exchange for a settlement. But that money didn't last very long. I've relied on grants ever since. If this project doesn't work...
Don't worry. It'll work. Let me just fix this up.
I'll brew some fresh coffee.
Be sure to run a diagnostic on the control unit. Could be a short.
Huh. No good. Gotta reroute this circuit.
Oh, why don't you do the honors this time?
I think we did it.
Next step, neural interface.
That's a lot of work for you to do by yourself. Sure you can handle it?
Apparently not, judging by today's debacle.
Because I still haven't found another job.
My funds are still...
I know. It's okay. Don't worry, I'll figure it out. What's a few bucks when you're trying to change the world, right?
To changing the world.
I missed a call from MJ.
Doctor, I need to go, but I'll be back later.
Don't worry, the work will still be here when you get back.
What's that?
Thank you.
Hey, sorry I missed your call. We still on for dinner?
Dinner? Oh, yeah. I was calling you about something else, but... yeah, we should talk over dinner.
The offer still stands for me to come over and cook.
Oh, really? Well, I like to take risks. I'm still out, but I'll grab some stuff at the store and let you know when I'm home.
Okay, talk soon. All right, dinner at MJ's. No expectations. It'll be hard to screw this one up. Guess I'll just freelance for a while until she calls.